Hello students, good morning. Welcome to yet another physics class from My Exam Coaching. Today we are going to see a very interesting topic, that is how a junction diode can be used as a half wave rectifier. It's one of the very important topic for your physics board exam class 12. Okay, so in the previous classes we have seen what is PN junction and how a forward bias and a reverse bias works. All these things we have already completed. Here we are going to see a junction diode is working as a half wave rectifier. Okay, so what is the corresponding diagram for this? Let us draw the diagram. First, initially we have a primary. Initially we have a primary, and the primary is connected to what? Primary is connected to an AC. So we have here an AC input. AC input. So AC current is given to the primary coil, and then correspondingly we have a secondary, and the two ends of the secondary are A and B. The end A is connected to the P end of a diode. Let us take this diode as D1, and then the N end is connected to a load resistance, and it is connected to the end B. So this is the corresponding diagram, and this part here you have a primary and here you have a secondary. So the primary coil and secondary coil, this part will work as what? This part will work as a transformer. So here you can say this is a transformer. So this is the required circuit diagram to show how a junction diode can be used as a half wave rectifier. Now, what happens when an AC input is given to the primary and how it works? So when an AC input is given to the primary, the secondary, that AC is available at the secondary, the two ends A and B of the secondary, when in the positive half cycle A becomes positive, suppose A become positive and A is connected to the P end of the diode D1. So what happens? Positive is connected to positive, this diode become forward bias. When this diode become forward bias, it will allow the current to pass through the load resistance RL, and it will pass through RL. So here you are getting, at the RL you are getting a flow of current. Similarly, in the negative half cycle, what happens? A become negative, so this will not allow the current to pass through D1, because D1 will become reverse biased. Okay, so actually what happens? Actually, at A, this is a cycle. So this is the cycle at A, and correspondingly what you are getting at the load resistance. When A become positive, this part, when A become positive, then the diode D1 will become forward bias. When diode D1 will become forward bias, then only it will allow the current to pass through. So there is a current passing through RL. So this is we are getting at RL, load resistance. Then when A become negative, the negative cycle, when A become negative, this is reverse biased. During reverse bias, what will happen? The diode will not allow the current to pass through. When the diode will not allow the current to pass through, this will not allow the current to pass through the load resistance. So at load resistance, no current will be available when A becomes negative. That means when A become negative, no current will be available here. Again, when A become positive, current will be available. And again, when A become negative, no current is available here. Again, when A become positive, current will be available. So this is what happening at the junction diode. Okay, at RL, you can see at RL you have, when A become positive, then only current flows through RL. So here you don't have a full wave rectification. Here you have only half wave rectification. In one cycle, you are getting only half wave. Another cycle, you are getting half wave. So what actually happens? The AC you are converting into DC, but it is not a full wave, it is a half wave rectification. So that is the reason a junction diode, in this case junction diode, is used as a half wave rectification. One of the very important topic for your board exam as well as your competitive exam, students, prepare well. Okay, while preparing physics, chemistry and mathematics of class 11 and class 12, students, if you have any doubt in any one of the topic, you can definitely contact us in this email ID, or if you want to talk to us, or if you want to contact us, you can call us in this mobile number. Okay, so definitely we will contact you back. And if you have any problem, all those problems will be solved. If you have any query, if you want to any particular topic, video on any particular topic, you can come, you can comment it in the comment box so that we can include it in the next video. Okay, prepare well for your exam. All the very best. Bye bye.